born from primordial stardust. 4.5 billion years ago, Jupiter was solar system's first planet. Jupiter is named after the Roman king of the gods. The ancients did not know precisely how big this planet was, but it turned out to be aptly named because it is the largest planet in the solar system, with more mass than all the other planets combined. It has a diameter 10 times that of the Earth and more than 1300 Earths could fit inside. The huge mass of Jupiter brings about an interesting phenomenon. The barycenter between Jupiter and the Sun is actually above the surface of the Sun at 1.068 solar radii from the Sun's center. I hear you ask, what is a barycenter? A barycenter is the center of mass between these two objects. With its huge size, Jupiter doesn't orbit anywhere close to the center of the Sun. The orbit, in fact, looks more like this, with Jupiter and the Sun rotating around the barycenter. As we know, mass affects gravity. Jupiter has a huge gravity over twice that of Earth's. This huge gravity is strong enough to tear asteroids apart, and without Jupiter acting as a cosmic vacuum cleaner, life on Earth would have never been possible. Jupiter doesn't really have a surface. Most of the planet is simply gas. Jupiter is made of lots and lots of hydrogen and helium, as well as lots of hydrogen-rich gases like ammonia, methane, and water. There is a huge layer of liquid hydrogen below the outer gaseous layer due to the high pressure produced by the immense gravity of the planet. Below all of this is a solid core made of iron, rock, and water. Probably the most iconic feature of Jupiter is a crimson-brown stone that's been raging for over 300 years, the Great Red Spot. It's a giant swirling vortex bigger than the entire Earth, with wind speed of up to 400 km per hour. Another storm known as Red Spot Jr. is also found on Jupiter's atmosphere. Jupiter has a thin ring system, which was not seen until the 1970s. The most impressive feature of Jupiter is its collection of moons. There are four very large ones, which were discovered centuries ago by Galileo and are called Galilean satellites. Ganymede is the largest of these moons and the largest moon in the solar system. It's actually greater in volume than the smallest planet, Mercury. It is a moon with an iron-rich liquid core. Its surface is covered with craters, and it is the only moon known to have a magnetic field and is even thought to have a subsurface ocean of liquid water. Next one, Callisto, is very similar to Ganymede. It is the most heavily cratered object in the solar system. Io is the moon that is closest to Jupiter, orbiting so closely that tidal forces are immense. Because of this, Io is covered with active volcanoes. Io is the most volcanically active object in the solar system. The smallest of the Galilean moons, Europa, is quite possibly the most interesting place in the solar system, because it may be the best candidate for potential extraterrestrial life that we are aware of. It has the smoothest surface of any known solid object in the solar system. There is a vast ocean of liquid water under the frozen crust. There are also red cracks which indicate the presence of minerals in the water. Something else to note about Jupiter is its remarkably strong magnetosphere. It is 20,000 times stronger than Earth's. The strong magnetosphere can interest two things: producing magnificent auroras and protecting the four bigger moons from solar winds, because they orbit within the magnetosphere. Jupiter is 778 million kilometers away from the Sun on average and completes its orbit every 12 Earth years. It rotates very fast, faster than any other planet, completing a rotation in only 10 hours. The axial tilt of the planet is only 3 degrees. This means it doesn't experience much change in seasons. Despite never achieving star status, it still formed a mini solar system of its own. Jupiter is also the third brightest object in the night sky after the Moon and Venus. We can be glad Jupiter is there, not only for its beauty, but because in so many ways it is an asset to our solar system.